Not many hospitals can boast the back end of a red London bus parked in the corner. But this one plays a vital part in assessing how patients who've had strokes will get on once they're out of hospital and trying to cope with everyday problems. Until recently, that's been very difficult to judge. But a report based on 3 years' research at the Stroke Rehabilitation Unit at St Pancras Hospital shows that patients who had a stroke while doing something active recover better than those who suffer a stroke while they're asleep. And through a series of tests, they can tell which patients can safely go home and who should stay in hospital. The stroke unit at St Pancras places a great deal of importance on catering for the individual needs of its patients.
We try to get to know our people, and we treat them all day long, and we talk to them in between. We find out what sort of people they are and what's important to them, and then it's very much easier to treat them and bring them back to what they really want to do.
The system worked for Andy Gill, who was only 19 when he had a stroke. 4 years later, Andy's recovered enough to work at a children's play centre.
The fact that there's eight, seven other patients around you, all of different levels of recovery, you can look back on someone who's just come in and say, oh, I used to be like that, or I've got this much better, or I've got this much to do yet. You can assess. By looking at other people, you can assess yourself more. Mm.
According to government statistics, strokes are the most frequent cause of chronic disability in Britain today. Doctors have come a long way in treating the victims, but admit they need much more money to complete their research. Tricia Ingrams at St Pancras Hospital. Tricia Ingrams, Thames News.